Well, welcome back. If you love to read and you're fascinated with American history, or maybe you know someone who is, we have an exciting new page turner. It's called Becoming Benedict Arnold, A Traitor Tale. That's a title that brings you right in. So let's get into it. Stephen Yoch is here. He's an award-winning author and a Minneapolis attorney. So welcome and congratulations on the book.
Yeah.
So we were talking beforehand. I'm always amazed at the amount of research that goes into this. Tell us about this book and about the path to writing it.
Yeah, you know, first of all, you find a good story, mm-hmm. and this is a story people don't know. And then I spend a lot of time just reading and reading and reading about the various stories relating to Benedict. And it came to a point where I felt compelled to tell the story. He starts from one of our greatest generals and greatest patriots to our most notorious traitor. And then I just can't stop.
Yeah.
And then I just keep writing.
And, you know, his name is now synonymous with being a traitor. And that's a word you bring up that is used a lot these days. People toss around that word traitor. So what are our modern day lessons from this book and what you've learned about Benedict Arnold?
Yeah, you know, I was just driving the other day and I heard, you know, Donald Trump is a traitor. Nancy Pelosi is a traitor. Kind of anybody that disagrees with you is a traitor. And the fact is, none of them are traitors. The Constitution defined what traitors are, and it's really important to know that Benedict committed treason, and then a few years later, they're writing the Constitution, and they really thought about Benedict Arnold as they were writing the Constitution. So it is a monumental level of treason to be a traitor in America, not just someone that disagrees with you, which I think was pretty smart, because otherwise we'd be hanging everybody all the time, every time they disagreed with us, right?
I don't think anyone wants that. That would be a bad path.
So he deserved it, they don't.
So tell us a little bit more about his path to becoming a traitor, because it's a really interesting journey that you lay out.
Yeah, I mean, he was one of our earliest patriots. He fought bravely, was wounded twice, was arguably our best battlefield general, and yet through intrigue and love and wounds and political stuff that's going on, he went into that dark path. And that his treason was so monumental that it surprised everyone, right? Mm-hmm. And that journey is really what my story is about, how you can go from someone who loves your country so much to being someone who really hates your country and now wants everyone you worked with to be dead.
Wow, so compelling. And of course, you bring up that if he'd succeeded, the revolution would have failed, history would be totally different, we wouldn't be standing here right now.
Absolutely. I mean, it's if he had succeeded, Washington and all his senior leadership would have been hung at the Tower of London.
Oh,
and we would have been probably a colony again, and our whole history would be different. We could be speaking German at this point. I mean, who knows? It would have been that butterfly effect. Right?
So, just so fascinating. It's a great book as you get into the holidays for anyone who's a history buff in your life. I know everyone's always kind of looking for those hard-to-get gifts for dad sometimes
or someone else, right?
But
exactly right.
This is also not your first book.
No, my first book was about George Washington his early life between age 14 and 27. He was the great hero of the French and Indian War, 20 years before the Revolution, and they learned the skills there to become our indispensable founding father. So that's the other book that I did, which was similar.
All right, well, very cool. And I know, how can people find out? Do you have a website where they can find out about book signings and things like that?
I do. First of all, obviously it's on Amazon, but also yoch.com, yoch.com, and I have both my books there, and you can buy both, also buy local if you go to my website.
Well, wonderful to have you here. Thanks. Sounds like a very compelling story. Thank you so much for your time.
You. It was really great.
All right. Again, that book's called Becoming Benedict Arnold, A Traitor's Tale. And as he said, it's available on his website, yoch.com and Amazon.